I went out to Colorado and I must have come up with 5 other possible things that I could do. And I kept thinking, well, maybe I could do something with trees. And then I'm looking out the window of my studio. There it is. There is a massive die-off of pine trees because of beetle kill. The only thing I really want to do is bring a ghost forest to downtown Manhattan. It's forests around the world dying off because of climate change. A couple people said you should look at the Pine Barrens in New Jersey, because after Hurricane Sandy had happened, the water got trapped behind a high part of the land. All these trees were dying off. Saltwater inundation, I've now learned, takes 3 to 5 years. What we really feel safe and comfortable bringing into the park would be a tree that was actually barely holding on to life. The salt water was already, it was like what you would call the walking dead. It was on its way out, but it was still technically alive. In the meanwhile, the engineers were hard at work figuring out how do you stand something like this up. And we now all know, like a telephone pole, and each tree is planted 8 feet under. I think the engineer originally had said, you need to go 6 feet. And I was like, 8 feet. We all wanted to sleep at night. We planted 6 trees in the ground in the Pine Barrens when we went out for the first time to inspect the trees. And we were able to determine that, okay, when we started, we had a variability of 25 feet to 45 feet in height. It didn't work. What you wanted was a consistency. So our trees vary in height from 38 to 45 feet. I sort of firmly believe that when you're making a work of art, even if it's a large scale one, you're manipulating and you're changing it and you're modifying it to suit the site. I had to kind of place each one in relation to its neighbors, and so that you'd have this dance between the trees. When it was all said and done, it was just so exciting. It was how the sunlight created shadows. The shadow that the piece makes is equal to the form. So you've got a 3-dimensional form, and then you've got a 2-dimensional drawing of that sculpture. So I think for me, just seeing the shadows that the trees are going to make become so much a part of the piece. You know, if you look at the Gothic cathedral, you're in awe of the scale of those wonderful vaults, right? And you feel like humbled by, but that's man making you humble of man, right? To walk through and feel like you were going to be able to have a dialogue with each tree, because each one is so different. As part of the artwork, we've calculated our entire carbon footprint for making the piece. And through the Natural Areas Conservancy, working with Madison Square Park, 1,000 native trees are being planted around the 5 boroughs, which will more than offset our carbon footprint, but also they will continue to absorb carbon. These natural beings that we've helped, you know, kill off, they're there to remind us of what nature can be and could be. There is something I hope people are moved enough to want to volunteer to help stop what's going on around the planet because of us. We could do it tomorrow. We could do this today.